Now for the day that I went so down that I sh** my pants. This was the most well-orchestrated prank I've ever seen in my entire life. I got pulled over by the cops at 10 to 6 in the morning.
This is now at about 7 minutes past 6.
Yo, Jim.
Yeah, how's it?
Cool, I've just got a bit of a hassle here with the cops.
What?
A bit of a hassle here with the cops. With a traffic cop.
I just want to sort this out.
Just hold on. This is my work plan, okay? I don't know. They just pulled me over and fines and shit and all that crap.
What fines?
Yes.
Outstanding fines, and they say the address is wrong and all this stuff. I've got to sort this out.
Sounds like
where are you, Darren?
I'm just at the bottom of Stanton Drive. It's just, I don't know, he's trying to think like he's a Rambo, yeah.
I'm now looking around the studio, Paul.
Yeah.
Can you see any cameras here?
No.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't see his laugh out loud at all, eh?
Are you sure?
Yeah, everything's man, yeah.
Did he pull you over for?
No, because I was driving it probably a little bit too fast, so I wasn't indicating changing lanes and all.
Oh, shit. Okay, Darren, listen.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, what is he arresting you for? Okay, you were speeding?
Yeah, and there's outstanding fines and...
What, you've got outstanding fines?
Yeah.
What, did they check that on the system or something?
Yeah, they did. Now they want to take me in.
They want to take you in?
Yeah.
Take you in what? Where?
Where? Where do you want to take me in?
The head office.
Where's that? Don't you have a local branch here?
Okay, Darren, what is his name?
Wenzel van Deventer.
Van Deventer?
Yeah.
His little voice is even higher than normally is.
Can I have a word with you?
Yes, yeah, sure.
Morning.
Peter, it's Jeremy. Yeah.
Good day, sir.
Yeah, well done. This is beautiful.
Yes, sir.
All right, thank you, sir.
Peter.
Yes.
Just make sure you take his phone away and switch it off, because if any of his mates hear it, then they'll start phoning him.
Okay, sure.
Okay. Let me just...
You know what? You see, sir, the problem is I cannot solve this problem on the side of the road here. What I'm going to do, does he work close to where I've stopped him here?
Yes.
What I was thinking of doing, Pat, leaving his car and then just take him to our apartment, because unfortunately he's untraceable, so...
But you know, I don't understand how you can say it's untraceable.
Now that we have the gentleman, I would really like to sort it out at our offices.
Okay, no, that's fine. Can I have a last word with him?
Yes, certainly.
Thank you.
Yo, Jim.
Yeah.
We're coming to drop my car off now, and then allegedly we're going to the head office, which I don't understand because there are many branches all around.
Is he police or JMPD?
JMPD. Okay, talk to him. I'm talking on a cell phone now. That's another charge.
We're just going to drop his car off, and then we're going to go to the Metro Police head office.
Yeah.
In town, just to sort it out.
Okay, Peter, just make sure that firstly, when you drop it off, he does not come up to the studios.
That's right, yes.
Secondly, make sure that his cell phone, you've got it, you take it away, or make sure it's switched off. And thirdly, make sure that he has no access to the radio.
Sure. Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, thanks, Peter. Bye. So let's get hold of Peter and ask Peter if we can speak to Darren, because on the other line I have Superintendent Wayne Minot, who is trying to sort this problem out with me.
Hello.
Peter, it's Jeremy. You're live. Can I speak to Darren?
Yes, just hang on.
Mr. Simpson? Hello?
Darren.
Yo.
Jeremy, how's it?
Yo, Jim, how's it?
All right, listen, I've got Wayne Minot on the line. I told him the guy's name was Wenzel van Deventer, is that right?
Yes, yeah. Okay. Wenzel van Deventer. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Now...
But Jim, you know what's like suspicious? That's why we could get hold of Dennis Audrey for me, okay? Because...
No, it doesn't help. Dennis Audrey is with South African Police Services.
Yeah, but that's where I am now. I'm at the SAP holding cells in John Foster.
Okay, well, no, they've just taken you to the holding cells, but you've been arrested by JMPD, so it's a JMPD thing, it's not a South African Police Services thing.
Yeah, but I've been handcuffed by the South African Police Services already, so if Wayne says it's not a South African police service thing, then why am I being arrested within the police station I'm going to break out?
If they put handcuffs on you?
Handcuffs, yes.
When
before I was read my rights for being arrested.
Wayne, they put handcuffs on him. This is unacceptable, man. He says he's down at Joburg Central, and he's in the SAPS custody.
You know what, Jim? I'm like down here in the road, down here, with guys that I think have been busted for selling crack cocaine in Hillbrow.
Okay, listen, what is the time? What, have you got your watch on?
It's about 7.
Yeah, right. That's when we usually do Whack Head's Window on the World. You know what? You have just been scammed, you little turd.
Yeah!
You bastard.
You've just been scammed, you little turd. They were waiting outside your house from 5:15 this morning.
You are joking. The lady even said, what is your status? I said, and I thought I was being a bit cocky. I said, I'm HIV negative. She said, oh, well, that's going to change.
Oh.